Right.
But it's in negotiating year, that's why you, we did the same thing on the Board of Ed.
But at the end?
Yeah.
Okay, there's a motion and a second on the court, except at 139-193. Any more discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Anybody opposed? Pass. Okay, jump over to 1421, legal. On 1421, legal. Mr. Pentec made a motion to accept the budget presented, we had to cut $7,000.
I'm at 61,550 right now?
61,550, correct.
I move we submit it at 61,550.
Motion made to submit the legal at 61,550. There a second?
Yes.
Second. I think Doug explained what he did, here. He took all the legal out of Erie's budget and just concentrated it in one budget, so all the legals together.
How was this reduced by $11,000?
It was shifted, when it was reduced.
I want an explanation of how.
I'm not sure.
I think I get your question. See if, well, I'll take a stab at it. Initially, the way it was set up with contacting the attorneys in town, people would just pick up the phone and call. Well, if you pick up the phone and call an attorney, the clock starts ticking, first 15 minutes of conversation. So what Doug is proposed to do is he's gonna draft a new rule and send it out to all department heads that if they need legal, if they want to contact an attorney, contact him first. He may already have the answer, rather than continually running to the attorney over something that may have already been either resolved or the question answered. So basically, avoid waste.
That's okay, but...
That's where he's anticipating his savings, by reducing the number of times that the attorney's contacted. And what had happened in the past is there was some kind of mix-up when people were charging between the attorney and the legal notices. Isn't that what you had said? It was the way that those were charged before I got here. There was a mix-up on how those went through.
I also have notes from last time that on the when we looked at last week, that traditionally legal fees included special counsel and notices, but Doug had already added special counsel to 5679. So that part of legal fees, part of 5603 was actually a duplicate.
Right.
Okay. But Doug didn't have a number for that when we met.
Any more discussion?
I thought we okayed it last
time. No, we didn't.
But I thought we okayed it at 65,550 is what I have written down.
I think we get it down even further.
Right, it's down further.
We reduced it further.
Okay.
So 61,550 is the number?
Yeah.
Okay. That's your motion.
Yeah, he made a motion.
Okay, any more discussion? All in favor accepting legal at 61,550?
Aye.
Anybody opposed? Okay. Go to 1423. Billing official.
How do you come back?
Which one?
1419. You read this fast? I know we want to increase them, which they deserve.
It's not we want to, it's the state law to increase them. Yes.
For the training, they have to travel to.
We have $3,800 for training. We've never had it before.
Right, because they never needed it before.
I'm talking about this salary. I'm not talking about the training. I'm not talking about transportation. That's added in.
Which
I'm talking about this.
That reflects the time that they go to trainings. You have to pay for the training, but they're going to be spending time as their registrars are going to train.
I know the guy in Thompson, he gets $7,000. A lot of people last year got, 5,500, whatever they had left. But, I think to increase it 100%, one way you got report is a big jump. And,
currently, our two registrars are thinking about quitting.
Well, we can't even do a budget just as a threat.
No, but I'm just saying, even with these two numbers, because they think it's gonna be a huge burden. So what I'm worried about is would we be able to replace it?
I don't know, that's, I just had a question.
Yeah, I'm just saying.
We're still on building official, right?
Yeah, I was just wanting to go back.
I just had a question about this one.
And that's why we passed on, this board passed.
Yeah, we did, I know, I understand.
So that's like.
I understand that, but.
I know.
What do we have?
All right, now 1423, the budget's up $20,042, because we moved the building official from a part-time to a full-time status. That's why that increase is so high.
And also Brenda was moved to this payroll.
And Brenda was moved from 35 hours to 40 hours a week.
What's the building official's salary?
$30,000 now?
No.
Now?
Yeah, right now.
Right now, yeah.
Yeah, $30,000.
He's part-time.
What's Brenda's salary?
About $54,000.
And I think her number of hours was increased slightly also.
Yes, 5 hours. Need a motion to do this, to have discussion? Maybe no one heard you, we need a motion on this.
So.
Motion made and seconded to approve the building officials to 117,914. Now discussion. Go ahead, Scott.
I've said this before, and I guess maybe it's short-sightedness, but do we need a full-time building official, or since we're gonna be opening up the charter, do we need a part-time building official and somebody to do the enforcement of the zoning? That's like, in my mind, that's the big question.
Well, we have two people, three people in the charter revision committee, maybe they can help. Doug? Did you hear that, I mean?
Well, by the time you get a charter revision, you know, this is gonna be 2 years down the road.
Right.
Well, my only thought on what's going on in Putnam is, you know, the Y's done, the high school's done, Walmart's done. I mean, yeah, there's always a chance to have bigger projects, but we got through all this with a part-time building official. Do we need a full-time guy? But I wanna put some money in there for zoning enforcement if and when the charter changes and we need that. But if it's not gonna be in this FY, I'm debating whether we need a full-time building official. That's my opinion.
Deb?
I don't think we have the luxury of deciding that we need a full-time building official. Partly because of the reason Scott just said, partly because of the number that we have at the end of this budget. So, I know we have a motion on the floor to go with the 117,914. I'll be voting against that motion to see if it fails, and then we can take some money out of there.
Okay, that's your right.
As a matter of curiosity, if that building official remained at part-time, what would that 117,914 go down to?
30,000 times 2.75.
That would be there.
Minus that.
Yep, okay.
And then would Brenda's thing change too?
No, Brenda would stay.
She's gonna keep that same.
Seems to be a discussion of all.
I got one question, and I don't know if anybody here can answer. How long is he here for? What do you think, how long he's here for?
10 hours, 20 hours a week.
Okay.
That's what we pay him for.
So he was here for that.
Not what I asked.
Yeah.
Well, it's hard to track that.
Okay.
He gets here at 7?
How hard is it to track, it's called time clock.
Because he's not physically present in the building for large portions of his time.
That's why I asked the question.
Right, but a time clock isn't gonna help figure that out.
Because if he's out in the road doing inspections and stuff like that.
Right.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
It didn't come up to what I thought it was gonna be, so that's why I'm.
Oh, okay.
So.
So you can vote this down, and then you can go to Doug's motion to reduce it, or you can approve it as is, and go from there.
I want to get that number.
Alan's gonna get that number.
So.
About 37,000, something like.
What is, well, 30,000 times.
2.75%.
I think the total for line item 5501 would come to 84,825.
Instead of 105?
No, because you didn't take into account, we increased Brenda's hours by 5.
I guess my question is gonna be, I'm sorry.
Brenda just said she's 54, right?
No, I just rounded that up, so.
If he's not gonna be full-time, why do we need Brenda 5 hours more a week?
Because it could give her, you know, equity with other, clerks.
Go ahead, Alma.
My question is, what is the salary that you have put in here for the full-time?
$65,000.
Okay, that's.
Five or 6.5?
6.5.
So he's not gonna get the increase if he's gonna get, go from full-time, from part-time to full-time, he wouldn't get the 2.75.
Which is $825.
He wouldn't get that, I would assume that.
No, it'd be based on 65, right.
So we just take 65,000 off the department, well, not 65, 30, 30,000. No, what's he make now, 30? Is he at 30 equal?
But full-time would be 65, there's a $5,000 bump. It's not twice, it's not twice 30.
So if we take 35,000 off the request, we should be where we need to be. But the difference between what he's getting now, is he getting the 2.75 with the 30?
No, with 30 would, yes.
Okay, so let me.
That would be 825.
So 30,825 would be his salary, so take the balance off that.
Okay.
That makes sense? Did I make any sense, Brenda?
Yep.
Okay.
So you're saying take 105,314 minus 30,825?
No.
No, that's what he would make, so take 105.
$5,000.
Right, minus the, well, actually, it's gonna be, let's do it this way, 65,000. Minus, what was it, 30,825, Doug?
30,825, you're right.
So take out 65 and then add in 30,825.
Exactly, yeah.
Okay.
And what do you call that?
I come up with the wrong number. Hey, I'm used to an adding machine. Minus 65.
You're good with this.
Plus 30,825, I can't do it on that. I got 71,139.
I have 83,739.
So I don't know what I did wrong.
We have our treasurer here, what do you have?
A piece of paper and a pen.
Okay.
But I, did you off the 122, Doug?
Yeah, that's for the total for the department.
Oh, okay.
83.
Yeah.
739.
I'm trying to plug in the regular, the 5501 line item. Because everything else is gonna add up.
And the social's gonna be affected. Right, I was just gonna ask, what's the percentage on social? 17? No.
0.0679.
Say that again?
0.0679 or 75.
Well, let's see if this motion fails. While we're waiting. It may all be for now.
The motion is to accept it at 117,914, who's in second?
Right.
Any more discussion? All those in favor of this, to have Department 1423 at 117,914, signify by saying aye? All those opposed?
Nay.
I think the aye of the chair, the nays have it. Motion is defeated.
It was close, though.
Okay, need another motion to discuss this?
Right.
I move that we make the, or keep the building official at a part-time basis, an annual salary of $30,000 plus the 2.75% increase this year, and every other line item remaining the same.
That first one?
Right. Yeah, it's the security.
So you're saying the total for that department will be 83,739?
That's what I came up with.
Okay, 71,139.
Yeah.
Seven, well, we gotta change those security, but.
No, but that's what the, that's 5501 is gonna be, 71.
71,139.
139.
Times 1.
Which is what I got the first time.
0679 equals minus, no, that was.
We're scrolling up here. Because last year was 84,393, and we didn't.
I know, that's why I said.
Oh, yeah.
That's why I was saying it doesn't make sense.
Hold on a minute.
I came up with that.
Unless Brenda's getting the salary sheet.
Yep.
Okay.
So anyway, my motion is to keep the building official at part-time.
Is there a second?
Say more on that, though.
Yeah.
No, I have a question.
This is during discussion, you can ask.
I'm not disagreeing with Scott, but we're going over numbers, not policy, right?
Right.
Well, both, sort of. I mean, if we're talking about if we're keeping someone part-time or putting them full-time, we're certainly talking about policy. Budgets are all about policy.
Scott, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, I obviously, if I said, hey, the salary's gonna be 71, and we're not gonna tell the guy, oh, and by the way, you're now full-time, you know, at a part-time salary, so I could, it's a catch-22, I guess.
Yeah, what we're doing here is we're allocating X amount of dollars.
Yeah, you're right. That's why I don't, that's why I didn't know the dollars.
More papers.
Do you want them?
Yes.
Okay, I think now I get what you're saying.
Yeah.
We all agree, what you're saying is we agree on the policy issue, right?
We really shouldn't, we're talking policy.
We're not discussing policy, we're discussing the number.
Yeah. Yeah, but numbers are always about policy.
Kind of, supposed to.
Yeah.
There you go.
Aha!
So the building official's 33 or 150?
Oh, see, that's where we're off.
That's where we're off.
Thirty or off. So we must've gotten the increase last year.
33, 153.
Yeah.
And I'm doing the 2.75 on that one?
I'm 33, or whatever it is.
Which would be 34,065. Right?
34,065, right.
34,065.
And what other line items would change other than that?
Well, you got, don't forget you gotta put Brenda in there.
Brenda's already in there. Right?
For
adding state.
Oh, yes.
I think there were those two figures at the one.
34,065 and 23,047?
No.
As to what current would be.
Brenda's full-time in that department.
Oh.
So those two positions are one individual.
22,430 and.
Oh, yes, you're right, yeah.
Right.
So we gotta add the 23,047 plus 21,006.
Right.
So that's 78,118 without Brenda's or either.
No, that's with it.
That's with it?
That's with it.
So that's 78,118.
And that's the only number that's gonna change?
No, because for the, Social Security and Medicare is gonna change based on that.
It would be less.
It would be less than 7,100.
Right, how much less? I'm not sure what percentage it's gonna.
Well, it went up 621. If you're eliminating the full, I would see, assume that, if it stays part-time, that it goes back down to what it was.
Might, but.
Oh, wait a minute, Brenda's went up a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit of increase.
But it was 64,79.
Something we allocated somewhere else? The help could have been 84. And now we're at 78.
Can anybody calculate that for us?
Calculate what?
Social Security and Medicare?
I don't know what the percentage is.
She's 765.
What's that?
765.
.765?
Yes. It depends on how you do running calculator. Because I usually do .07665.
.07?
Yeah.
Yeah.
59,763.
Okay, that doesn't look right because last year was 65,95.
But look at the difference in salary. That's what I was saying. Last year we had 84,383. Today we have 78,118. So we have a difference in salary.
You took the flat salary from last year.
And that's why.
That's the part that.
All right, then I'll go one step further. Last year we had a part-time building official and we had Brenda. And to put those back in the budget, the number shouldn't be lower. It shouldn't be 78,118. It should be higher than 84,383. Or am I missing something?
Does somebody else under that?
The simple thing to do is to take 84,393 and add
2.75%.
Right.
That had to be flat.
Plus the.
$5 for Brenda.
That's 200 hours a week, or 200 hours a year.
That's 6,300.
260 more hours.
Difference is $6,275.
What's the hourly figure, Brenda?
I have to get a contract.
You have.
I have. Want me to get it?
That's the only way for us to get a number.
You want me to get it?
If you got a contract.
I think I have a copy of it.
So has there been a, there's a motion on, what's the motion on the floor?
The motion on the floor is to change, and I put a number on it, which I should, because we're not talking policy.
So let's kill that motion.
Yeah, all right, we'll kill that, yeah. I'll rescind that motion and we'll wait for a number.
Yeah, because I would.
Who seconded that?
I'm rescinding my second.
Because I got two more questions on the line items on this budget. Professional services is slated for 3,000. I think I asked this question last week and I can't remember what the answer was, but you know, it may be one of those where you pay at the end of the year things, because if you look at, is that what it is and what is it?
We need something more to go.
Okay.
What was the answer?
I'll forget that one. Books and magazines, $700 a year that he hasn't used yet. I'm sure he doesn't buy all his magazines at the end of the year, right?
I wonder if Brenda does anything with that. I don't know.
Right. Well, but nothing's been spent in the prior 2 years. Is that?
I recommend we ixnay that from the budget.
So when you make the motion, whenever we get that number,
you could add this.
Yeah, just put that after
700.
That's land use.
Yeah, we'll be adding confusion here.
Yeah, no, I don't want to do that.
Norm, how you doing back there?
Wonderful, thank you.
Thank you for that report on that fire. I read one of the two.
What I'm looking for are any particular comments that may stick out. That's what I'm looking for before I finalize it.
It was scary. So the comment I can make on it. I didn't look at the Whipple Street one yet. There was no deaths at Whipple Street.
No. Next one is Walden. I'm working on that one now.
You guys look like accountants, am I right?
Yeah. Pricewaterhouse?
Yeah.
Where are you guys from?
From Tango Lighting. We're here to provide a presentation on LED street lighting.
Oh, you're in the wrong place. You're down the street.
No.
189.
No.
Chances are you missed the meeting.
Absolutely.
189 Church Street.
I was given this address.
Well, they're wrong.
Right.
We provided
them.
Well, Ricky's wrong.
Oh, boy.
Call Ricky and see if he's a
candy for us.
For you guys.
Yeah, you should have been on 189 Church Street.
Well, thank you guys for pointing out to us.
It's only right down the street. Okay. You can find the police station, it's right there.
Oh, yeah,
it's in the blue light.
That's where we were last time, so.
Yeah.
Wait.
All right.
Oh, thanks, guys.
Hopefully they're still there.
Sorry about that, guys.
No, we enjoyed listening to it. Right?
I'm just concerned we don't waste our chance.
No, I know we can't. Usually lasts like 12 minutes.
What? Since it's budget season for them too, minutes.
I know, which is why he had mentioned it was going to take us a few more items.
All right, thank you. Have a good day, fellas.
Thank you very much.
I could have found it.
See, that was your fault. because the town administrator, she said, hi, gentlemen, what are you here for?
I thought there was something in me that I wasn't aware of.
I almost was going to ask.
Me too.
But I figured that.
I figured that would be the accountant's, like, maybe they're talking about our audit. I'm like, oh, they're.
Oh, you'll be happy with that.
Well, one of us said it was the meeting just on the budget. So I thought they were, you know, students.
Well, they could be including that as part of their budget.
Right, I thought they were students who were coming in for some kind of class requirement. I came up with a whole bunch of scenarios for them.
I'll finish myself.
Oh, no, you don't. No accidents with the scooter.
Well, you will.
Say again?
I'm sorry.
No.
Do you have whips around here?
Ruthie, mom.
Oh, I can
Is the dipper thing still going on?
Christ, it's unbelievable.
Okay, there are two representatives for street lighting, they're heading over there now, they were here at the Selectmen's meeting. So, I don't know if you can page them or alert them, but hang on for a couple minutes, okay? Okay.
Do you guys want to share this one?
You guys want to say this one?
The street lighting representatives were supposed to be addressing the district. Thank you.
You did?
Brenda's gonna be on the top scale.
I have a feeling they missed. Probably.
Police chief is walking out.
Someone's gonna have to find hope.
Thank you.
She's at 2273.
An hour?
Yep. So she's up to 47.
Okay, so she's not.
I do that at 40 hours, I do that at 40.
All right, here we go. That total is the additional 260 hours times that hourly figure comes to 5,902.
If we add the 2.75% on top of that?
And then we add the 2.75.
So what did you say, 5,001?
5,910.
No, 275 is already added on a union contract.
Yes.
So the 2273 reflects the 2.75.
7,000, that's what it is, $6,072. And then what did I just say we were different, the difference was? Difference was? That's what it is.
That's what it is.
Yep.
All right, are you making a motion on this?
You got that there? It is what?
What's the?
The difference was the Brenda's 5,000, whatever it was, what for the 5 hours.
Included the 275.
Right. So that was for additional last year for overtime, is that correct? Tony, I'm asking?
Yes.
Okay, so now, because did we not pay her for, we increased her to 40 hours?
Starting next year.
So okay. The difference of that, is that what, where the 6,000 is?
I would think so, but it just seems in a $5 million budget, we're nickel and dime to see. Give me a number, let's get rolling here.
Well, we're trying to, but I'm trying to figure out where the $6,000 difference is. If that's what she was, because we increased her by 5 hours,
right.
Is that what we're paying her additionally, or is she getting her hourly, that would be her hourly rate if we paid her 35 hours before, I know we're paying at 40.
That's hourly, her hourly rate.
And that's, and then that includes the raise.
Right, so that's what it is.
So 59.10.
Yes, let me back up. Whatever you calculated out was, if you take what that 5,000 and change, if we take, because she's getting paid for 40 hours instead of 35 this year, she's getting 40, so the difference between her 35 hour a week pay and the 40 hour week pay is going to be, or for, should I say over the year, is going to be the 6,000 and change. Because if you take her hourly rate and multiply it by 52 weeks, it should.
$5,909.80.
Now multiply that by the 2.75.
It's already included, he was saying.
That's already included.
Not to get back to where we are. Not to get back to where we are. If you just humor me and multiply that by 1.0275.
What the 59?
162.52.
So So 162 plus the 5910 is gonna give you the difference between, which is $6,075 or something close to that.
$6,072.32.
So, so it's, that's what the differential is, because her hourly's going up.
I trust you.
You're basing on last year's. You're basing on last year's, that's why it's on the 2715.
I make a motion, we accept.
Yeah, does that make sense?
Is there, does somebody got a bottom line number?
There are no numbers.
Oh, wait.
Line 5501, what would the regular payroll be?
I think it was $90,303.
$90,000?
I don't know, but I took the 59 and the 84. You gotta add the 2.75 on the 84.
No, I can tell you this, hold on.
I'm trying to bring it all in.
I have a calculator.
23047 plus 1106.
Because again, we got 105 in there. Take out 35.
Right.
Okay? Add in, say, $6,000 for Brenda. Okay? Now the difference is 24.
I think that 105 was light.
Yeah, what's the...
Minus what, 35?
Because Tony took that out.
Well, 40 hours at 2273 times 52 is $47,278.
For Brenda?
Brenda.
Is that the 275? Are you taking it off the...
$47,000 what then?
The 275's already added in.
$47,000.
So it's 2273 this year.
Yep.
And it's times 40, times 52.
$47,000 what?
278 and change.
Times 52.
Right.
And then in January, there's another bump. Right?
Yeah.
She's already...
She's at the top.
Okay, so 47,278, it's 2.75.
No.
Yes, to get your social security, right. No. The 2273, the hourly rate, is this year's factored in with the increase.
Okay, so 47,278...
Is her salary or her wages.
For next year.
Right, this year. Yeah, for next year.
Okay. So now we add in $30,825, right?
No, he's $33,000.
Yeah, he's, yeah.
He's 33.
He's $34,065.
$34,065.
And your sheet?
It's $81,343.
So you're gonna add $16,000.
It's in the dark gray, building official.
81...
343.
340.
Oh.
81,343?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And 40 cents.
And 40 cents. Go 44.
And you got, are you next to 700?
Yep.
And, I'm sorry, so 81...
So I'm just waiting for Roy to come up with his number.
Times 0.7%? 87,566 and 17 cents.
Is that what you want, reduced to?
No, that's with the social security, so let me get out.
Yeah, but just the social is 6223.
Right, see, I did in whole, so I can get to that.